Yo guys! Today I will show you how to create this fantastic loop, using Cinema 4D, Jace Placement, and After Effect. First of all, open Jace Placement. And select Jace Placement 2. Jace Placement is a program that allows you to create procedural textures, and allows you to save the black and white map, normal map and color. Just play with these four sliders. Until you find a texture you like. Then click on Toggle Color, and choose the color palette you like best. Then create a new folder, and save the created textures inside, by clicking on Save High, Save Color, and Save Normal. We can now switch to Photoshop, which will allow us to create an alpha texture, which will help us to create more details. Open the high map texture, and play with the levels, and curves, like I do, in order to get an image, with, only white, and only black, like I did. Eventually you will have four textures like these. Now we can move to Cinema 4D. Create a new material, open Node Editor and drag Diffuse, Height, and Normal Texture. Create a Displacement node. Connect the textures to the material like I do. Use the displacement settings based on your scene, you can fix them better afterwards. Create a tube, and rotate it, by 90 degrees. As tube settings, set the inner radius equal, to the outer radius, and, as height, insert a value, that you will have, to remember shortly. Apply the material, on the tube. Create Octane Sky object. Start preview render, and start to fix displacement setting, and tube settings. Create a camera, and set all coordinates, and rotations to 0. After this, set your tube, in the same way as the camera. Now go on Motion Tracker menu, and create a cloner object. Then, set the tube as a child of the cloner. Change the coordinates of the cloner, to have the same point of view of the camera. Now, copy the height of the tube, and paste the same value in the z-axis of the cloner position. And increase the count of the cloner. Create a disk object, rotate it by 90 degrees, and increase the size, until it closes the tube. And moves the disk, to the bottom of the tube. Now create a diffuse material, in emission setting select black body emission. Click on with square image, and check surface brightness, and scale down the intensity at 25. Apply this material on the disk. Now right click on camera, and add Octane camera tag. Go in post-processing settings, enable it, and increase the bloom power as you like. If you want, you can add a high dynamic range imaging on environment tag on your sky object. The color and the environment depend on your image. If you need the scene brighter, you can add an octane light and set it as child of the camera. Now we can make the animation. First of all, go on the first keyframe, then click on camera, and jump into the coordinate setting. Click on the circle near the Z-axis, until it became red. Then go on the last keyframe, and move the Z-axis, as the same value as tube height. As you can see, the width light in the middle is not looped. To fix that, just put the disc as child of the camera. And increase the clone value like I do. To have the loop at a constant speed, open the timeline, F curves. Select the camera. Select the points. And click on the linear icon. Finally, add details to make your loop unique. My blue lights are not in a loop. To loop, you need to clone the tube, reduce the radius, and insert the second tube in the cloner. And obviously play with the material's offset settings. Now open render settings. Increase the max samples based on your scene, and set the priority to high if you want your render faster. In Cinema 4D render settings, choose your resolution. Select Octane Render. In Save setting, choose your folder location, and choose PNG. In Output setting, select all frames, and click on render icon. When the render has finished, open After Effects. Create your composition. Right-click on project window. Import, select the first image of your loop. Check PNG sequence and check create composition. Import the loop sequence into your composition. And start to make some magic with post-production, adding some effects like glow, curves, and hue and saturation. You can also use other program to make post-production. I hope the video was useful to you. I invite you to subscribe to the channel, to leave a like, and to love art, a nice way to leave your signature throughout your life. See you at the next video. Madness.